8 out of 10. That's the high-grade research group Strat-Based ADR Institute gave President Bongbong Marcos Jr. on his first year in office. At a forum in Pasig City, the group's president, Dindo Manhit, says reforms and new policies have started under the Marcos administration, and he sees strong prospects for a more collaborative and transparent governance.
Maybe 8 out of 10, great, because of where we are today. His first big project was just simply opening up the economy. Our data reflected the opening up of the economy made people find jobs again.
Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri also gave Marcos Jr. the same grade, asserting that the president is doing his best.
I give the president 8 out of 10. Number one, napakasipag niya. From day one, he started this mandate running. Ika nga, he started it running. Of course, he's being hounded by inflationary problems, problems of high cost of goods, high cost of food and fuel.
Both Manhit and Zubiri also explained why they did not give the president a perfect 10.
Kailangan po niyang ayusin yung value chain, kailangan niya ayusin yung concept na farm to table para wala nang middlemen. The president should look into increase in labor, yung tinatawag natin na minimum wage. Napakababa. Tanayin mo yung kababayan po natin na yon. They're all miserable.
Our programs should respond to the concerns of the people. And right now, the concerns is presyo ng bilihin, mabigat. Kulang kami sa trabaho, mababa ang sahod. And we cannot rely on OFWs alone. We cannot rely on BPOs. We need an investment-led growth trajectory where jobs can be created.
Meanwhile, an agriculture group gives Marcos Jr. 7 out of 10 in his performance as agriculture secretary. The group SINAG believes Marcos still needs to do more. That is why it sees no problem with him staying on as agriculture chief.
Nakita natin na yung production ng rice, kailangan itaas pa yung production. So, kailangan natin siya doon. Kung in case na anong kailangan na budget for that, madaling may pasok and may bigay sa ating mga magsasaka.
But political analyst Michael Yusinko says Marcos's most telling failure in his first year is not appointing an agriculture secretary.
Even on the promise of pursuing food security or achieving or attaining food security, I think he has failed to lay the groundwork or to really solidify the building blocks towards that goal, precisely by his failure to designate a regular Secretary of Agriculture.
But the Ibon Foundation gave Marcos Jr. a failing mark. It says instead of addressing socioeconomic needs of the people, the president has prioritized the Maharlika Investment Fund and the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, which it says only benefit the elite few. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.